Hey everyone, and once again, welcome to WsCube Tech English channel. Myself, Umar Taskeer. As in this particular video, we are basically going to talk about the auction insight option, which is present there in the keyword report in Google Ads, right? So we'll be discussing about what are auction insights and what kind of information we are going to see in auction insight. So before actually starting this video, I would like to request you to please do subscribe this channel and don't forget to press the notification bell so that you do not miss any one of the upcoming important videos. So guys, as you can see on my laptop screen, if I want to access auction insight, we have to come over here and we have to go to this keyword section over here, and then we have this auction insight option present over here, right? So first of all, I would like to tell you that auction insight is only available for the search campus and shopping campus. Earlier it was also available for display campus, but now it is not available for display campus. It is only available for search campus and shopping campus. Now what auction insight tell us? See, auction insights tell us the report of how we are performing and how our competitors are performing within an auction. So we know that whenever we want to advertise on Google search engine result page, whenever we want to show our ad on Google search engine result page, no matter if it is Google search ad or it is Google shopping ad, if we want to show our ad in Google search engine result pages, so we have to basically go through an auction, right? So when we take participation into that auction, along with us, our competitors also take participation into that auction, right? So what kind of report, what kind of impression share, what kind of positions we are getting there in the auctions, all these things, this auction insight report will tell us. So as you can see over here, we have this U over here, and then we have a list of our competitors or the list of other domains which were there in the auction. And you can see over here, it's impression share, overlap rate, position above rate, top of the page rate, absolute top of the page rate, and outranking share, right? So now let me tell you, what does this impression share actually means, right? So guys, the impression share means that suppose if your ad is like eligible to show for 10 times, right, the eligibility of your ad to show or to appear or to trigger is 10, and you got only 5 impression, which means that your impression share is 50. So you have your impression share over here, you have your competitors impression share over here, and I believe you are performing good with regards to the impression share that you have, right? Then there is overlap rate. So guys, overlap rate is like how often another advertiser's ad received an impression in the same auction that your ad also received an impression. So if you and your competitor or some other advertiser also got an impression in the same auction, then it will be called as overlap rate. So you can see over here is we both have an overlap rate of like somewhere around 19%, right? So this is the overlap rate, and then we have position above rate. So it is how often another advertiser's ad in the same auction shows in a higher position than your own when both of your ads were shown at the same time. So if both of the ads are shown at the same time, by how much percentage your competitor or other advertiser is above your ad, right? So it's like position above rate. Now here we are seeing another report, which is like top of the page rate. Top of the page rate tells us that let's say if your ad is shown like 10 times, and out of those 10 times you got 7 impression at the top of the page, right? At the top of the page, right? So guys, whenever we see search engine result page, like if we type over here digital marketing course, if we type digital marketing course over here, okay, and whatever ad we are about to see, like these one, right? So all these 4 ads are present at the top of the page, right? All these 4 ads are present at the top of the page, whereas when we come down over here, we are having 3 ads over here also. These are basically at the bottom of the page, right? And all these 7 ads are present at the first page of our search engine result page. This is how we basically categorize that where our ad is showing. So if we come back to our audience insight section over here, we can see that top of the page rate over here, and this is like this section over here where 4 ads are actually showing. This is the top of the page rate, and at the bottom we have this bottom of the page rate over here. So somewhere out of 10, 7 times our ad is shown in the top of the result pages, whereas other competitors like booking.com, they were like 9 times in the top of the page, right? So if they got 10 impression, more than 9 times their ad is present at the top of the page, right? So this is what this actually means, right? Then we have absolute top of the page rate. Absolute top of the page means that the first position. So now we are going to talk about absolute top of the page rate. So you can see over here, it's saying that you got 43.17% of absolute top of the page rate, which means that out of 10 times your ad is at the first position. When we say absolute top of the page, which means that I am talking about the position number one. So out of 10 times, 4 times our ad is at the position number 1. It's ranking at position number 1. This is absolute top of the page rate. Now when we talk about the outranking share, it is again a very important metric. Outranking share is basically how often your ad ranked higher in the auction than other advertisers ad, or if your ad showed when there did not, right? So this is now something very relative. So now how you are performing or how you outranked others, this is what this report tells us. This is what this column is telling us. So that's it. This again is a very important report. And so guys, whenever you are seeing this report, which is like auction insight report, you have to work on your bidding, right? You can derive conclusions from this report that how your bidding should be, what amount you should bid, right? Or you have to make changes in your bidding amount, like if you have to increase your bidding amount, or if you have to decrease your bidding amount, or if you have to increase your budget. So all these conclusions you can actually make after seeing this auction insight report. So that's it for this specific video. See you in the next video. Till then, goodbye.